Hey everybody, I am Sarah. Welcome back to Overkill Reviews. This is Banger's weekly heavy metal review show. I have not been very active around these parts, especially this summer, because my band Smolder was recording our second studio album and playing some festivals and shows, which we will continue to do a lot of in 2023. But I am back so that I can review an album by a American traditional heavy metal band who recently replaced their iconic vocalist. That's right, it's the new album from Summerlands. It is called Dream Killer, and it is out now via Relapse Records. So, Summerlands formed in 2013 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, United States, and they released their excellent self-titled debut in 2016. Really liked this record quite a lot. Made up of multiple members of Eternal Champion and Stone Dagger, you know, bands that I have talked a lot about on Banger a lot. The band is a 80s stadium metal worshipping counterpoint to the obscure weirdness of Eternal Champion, featuring bassist Brad Robb, drummer Justin Detour, guitarist John Powers, guitarist and engineering mastermind Arthur Rizik. These guys have a collective Metallum page that puts most other modern musicians to shame. Initially, they were fronted by iconic vocalist Phil Swanson, who you can hear on projects like Hour of 13, Smith and Swanson. I'm pretty sure he did something with Atlantean Codex. He's also done Solemn Lament. This guy's got a huge resume and back catalog. Despite them being kind of a super group of sorts, Summerlands performed fairly infrequently, and it seemed like they might be destined to be kind of a one-off recording project. But then this year, they announced that Phil was out and that Brendan Radigan of Magic Circle and Pagan Altar would be taking over on vocals. And anyone who has watched any of my reviews knows that this combination, oh. Now, here's the personal caveat. When they announced that Brendan joined the band, I was stoked. But then when I heard the first single, the 7-inch single, Ageless Life, I was deeply concerned about this record. It just didn't do anything for me. And of course, when Banger asked me to review the album, I of course said yes, because I wanted to give it a fair shot and do a deep listen and see what I was going to think. So what did I find? Let's find out. Okay, so point number one that I wanted to talk about with the new Summerlands album is about great pacing. I know that this is a favorite phrase of mine, but this album is a grower, not a shower. I initially mentioned that I didn't like the single Heavens Above from the Ageless Life 7-inch. But the more I listened to the record, the more I liked it. And it's because the opening track, which is called Twilight Points the Way, it's like midpoint paced and driving. And then it's followed by the relaxed and subdued Heavens Above, which then leads into the driving song, and which is also galloping. It's called Dream Killer. And then there's Night Rider, which is a slow burn intro. It's mid tempo. And the chorus is like nicely accompanied by keyboards and sultry solos. And, just listening to the record over and over made me really like want to reinforce the point about how important pacing is in a record, because it can change your appreciation and understanding and like love for certain songs. And it also can make you just realize as a musician how important pacing is to the overall structure of a record. Yeah. This album, Dream Killer, it's definitely in the vein of 80s arena heavy metal bands. Think specifically bands like Ozzy, Rat, Dokken, Sabbath, you know, bands that were playing massive arenas in the 80s. And also think of Judas Priest, specifically the dual guitars and the visual aesthetics. Like the bands that I mentioned, Summerlands is big, muscular, fun. It's fun music. And if you look at their very Top Gun-esque video for Force of the Storm, you're going to see a lot of commonalities, specifically to Turbo Lover. I think we should even compare a few sections of the videos, because I think that there's some very loving homage nods going on here, and it really reinforces the lineage that Summerlands comes from and the sound that they are going for, even if the Summerlands video is like, albeit a bit lower budget. ¶¶ Now, let's go forward a little bit and watch how those vocalists are being juxtaposed singing while the action is continuing around them. It's great. And finally, who could forget action shots of musicians playing just like these? I spy like no other. It's great. I love it. I think that this is personally the most important part of continuity from the previous record, which was also just like resplendent with solos, particularly in tracks like Timeless and Seventh Seal. Like Summerlands does the solos, does like the musicality. Like it's not like they're, you know, Igni fucking Malmsteen, but they're playing great solos that are high energy, that serve the music, and they know when to stop. Rather than me talking about the guitar work, I just want to play you some fun solos. Here's the solo from Dreamkiller. Here's the solo from Edge of a Knife. Oh my god, also great. This is my one negative thing about the album. Brendan is an amazing singer, there is absolutely no doubt about that. He sounded incredible in Magic Circle and Pagan Altar, but the frequent double layering of his vocals in this band often makes it sound suspiciously like he is auto-tuned, and it gives certain vocal intonations like a metallic and unnatural sheen that I do not like, and that is being exacerbated by his like unusual nasally higher pitch. I know this vocal doubling effect is a technique that Arthur is a big fan of, and he uses it to incredible impact on a lot of his records, but in my opinion, it works much better on other records than it does on this one, and like, it is used relatively sparingly, but in the moments that it is used, I always notice it. So, here's an example. Yeah, so that dance on the edge of the knife moment, not for me. It also happens in Heavens Above Here. So as I said, this effect on this album, it just doesn't do it for me. But I've raved about this album for multiple minutes that I pointed out one bad thing, just like I did for the Eternal Champion record. Will that ruin the album rating, or is it just going to make a bunch of people froth raving mad in the comments despite the numerous other compliments? Let's find out. Well, this is a big, fun, concise, punchy, rewarding album. It makes me want to jump in like one of those jet simulator type games in an arcade with a beer and a bunch of like friends who actually like their lives and enjoy heavy metal, and know that heavy metal can be like life affirming, and blast that record and just like blast off into space. It's really fun. It's high energy. It's got bright lights. It's rewarding. It's one of those things you want to play on a Friday night when you got your buds over and you're all having a sauna and having a fucking party. Because that's what we do in Finland. For all those reasons, it's getting 4 skulls out of 5 here on Overkill Reviews. So next up, it is time for the shoutouts. First, I want to shout out to Marth, who got signed to Southern Lord. Congratulations, bitch. You fucking deserve it. Now, for the other shout-outs, there is a debut album by Sonya. It's released on September 23rd via Cruz del Sur. It's got liberal dose of both trad metal and post-punk goth rock. It's called Loud Arriver. It's excellent. Next up, I have to recommend the full length by the black metal band Guds for Let. This one-man atmospheric black metal band released the album Friendship, Love, and War on September 2nd. Another one on my list of suggestions is the debut album by solo Native American black metal band Black Braid. It is new and it is out and it is heavy and vicious. It's called One. Last but not least, Winnipeg-based noise rock outfit Ken Mode have added a full-time saxophonist / synth player / pianist / percussionist and backing vocalist Catherine Kerr to the fold. And she is giving the band a bizarro injection that is similar to John Zorn meets Napalm Death vibe. And you should just listen to Utilitarian if you don't know what I'm talking about, because that shit is wacky good. Their new album, it is called Null, and it is out September 23rd via Artifact Records. All right, that's it. Nice to be back. Bye.